Val is a film about the life and career of one of the most iconic actors of our time, Val Kilmer. The scene I chose is when Val goes back to Arizona after his mother passes away. I picked this scene because it exemplifies so many things that I love about documentary.
My mother passed on.
Premiere was the obvious choice for us on this project. Val had over 800 hours of footage in his personal archive, digitizing different sizes, different codecs, different frame rates, and being able to work with it all in one sequence was crucial. Our film is like a collage of pictures. And working in Premiere is kind of the same way.
Oh, Val, that's not funny, look.
It allows you to collage images and work with media in a way that's like painting.
That's not funny, and it's not kind, and it's not nice, and it's not environmentally friendly.
I see the scene as a crescendo, in a way. It's a slow build.
Yo, you got me.
It's meant to be very subjective, and you're meant to experience it as if you're Val in this dreamy tapestry. We would just gravitate towards scenes that we had an emotional response to. So this scene was actually cut very early. When he gave us the footage, I immediately recognized the drive up to her house as something I'd seen from footage he had shot in the 80s. I saw an opportunity to intercut the two in a way that brings depth and emotion to the scene.
Hi, Val! I'm happy you're here.
Val ended up mirroring a lot of the same shots that he did almost 30 years prior, which made the intercutting even more interesting. My favorite part, oddly, in the scene is when the dog runs up to the car. I tried to prelapse the sound here of both his mom and her dog to pull us into his memories of them. The sound is what we use as cues to go back and forth between present and the past. Markers are my favorite thing. When you're cutting a 2-hour long feature, it gives you a visual representation of your scenes.
Hey, Val, here's something for you.
This is for you.
To see it in my timeline and each scene represented, not only in terms of length, but in terms of placement, you can look at it all in one frame and quickly just play around with moving entire scenes based on this visual representation. Stepping into this place, you can almost hear voices and the sounds that used to be there 30 years ago. This is something that only film can do, which is to magically transport us between time and space and connect moments and memories without saying a word.
I wrote something nice last night all about her style, her hairdo, and her jewelry. That was pop.
I just feel very privileged to have been trusted with putting not just this scene, but the whole film together.